starting with the Cournot equilibrium. Cournot equilibrium is also in the same oligopoly model. So it's the same. It's in the same oligopoly model that we discussed in the Bertrand in the last video, which has two firms selling homogeneous product. The difference between Bertrand and Cournot is, in Bertrand we said price was the choice variable, in Cournot Q is the choice variable. So we have to actually differentiate profit with Q, not with respect to price. So we are given an example that P is equal to A minus Q. You notice how this is only a single demand curve. So when we have one single firm, when you have two firms having a single demand curve, it implies that the product is homogeneous. क्योंकि अगर product differentiated होता तो उसमें अलग अलग prices हो सकते, तो हमारे पास demand curves दो होते, one belonging to a single firm. But right now we have a single demand curve which is not belonging to a single firm, which is overall the demand curve for the industry. So this demand curve is the demand curve for the industry. So this can actually be rewritten as, this is, we're trying to find out the profit of the ith firm, given that I can be one or two, given that it's a two firm industry, which is equal to P as a function of Q, price, into the quantity of that ith firm minus the total cost function of the ith firm. So this is my profit of the ith firm. Given the profit of the ith firm, we figure out the quantity which maximizes profit for this ith. So once we have this, we can actually use numbers and clarify it. So let's assume that C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C, which is actually equal to MC, but since C is constant, this is equal to AVC. So my total variable cost is nothing but AVC into Q, right? So if it's 1, then it's Q1. So it's just nothing but C into Q1. So mind you, I'm not multiplying with Q1, I'm multiplying AVC with Q1. Agar hame MC se total variable cost चाहिए तो हमें इसको इंटीग्रेट करना पड़ेगा, मल्टीप्लाई नहीं कर सकते. लेट्स ऑल्सो फर्दर अज्यूम देयर इज नो फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट, सो दैट मीन्स माई टोटल कॉस्ट इज नथिंग बट टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट ऑफ फर्म 1, राइट? इफ वी हैव दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन, देन व्हाट इज पाई 1? पाई 1 इज नथिंग बट पी इंटू Q1 माइनस सी इंटू Q1, विच इज ए माइनस Q1 माइनस Q2 द होल इंटू Q1 माइनस सी Q1, which can be rewritten as A minus C into Q1, this is not 9, this is A minus C into Q1, minus Q1 Q2 minus Q1 square. ये हमारे पास आ गया, right? ये हमारे पास आ गया. So I'll just rewrite it again. This is nothing but A minus C into Q1 minus Q1 Q2 minus Q1 square. Then we do del pi 1 by del Q1, which is A minus C minus Q2 minus 2Q1, putting it equal to 0. So Q1 is equal to A minus C minus Q2 upon 2. This is my reaction curve of firm 1, or the best response curve of firm 1. So this defines how much quantity would the firm 1 produce given whatever quantity firm 2 is producing. Firm 2 ke hisab se firm 1 kitna produce kar rahi hai, that's given by this curve. Similarly, when you solve for firm 2, you get Q2 to be equal to A minus C minus Q1 upon 2. अगर यहाँ पे हमारे पास C1 C2 इक्वल ना होते तो ये C1 होता, ये C2 होता. रेस्ट इफ इट रिमेन्स द सेम, देर इज नो डिफरेंस. वी आर गोइंग टू यूज दीज टू कर्व्स लेटर. आई जस्ट वांट टू शो यू हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स और द रिएक्शन कर्व ऑफ फर्म 1 एंड फर्म 2, राइट? नाउ वी एक्चुअली गो बैक टू द जेनरिक फॉर्म. हमारा जो बर्ट्रांड मॉडल होता है, सो आई एक्चुअली वांट टू गो बैक टू द बर्ट्रांड मॉडल क्विकली बिफोर कमिंग बैक टू द Cournot मॉडल. जब हमने बर्ट्रांड किया था तो हमने बोला था द टू फर्म्स आर सेलिंग प्राइस इक्वल टू मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. सो इसलिए हमारा जो प्राइस था, दैट वाज कमिंग आउट टू बी सी, दैट पी स्टार वाज कमिंग आउट टू बी सी. सो माई टोटल कोड आउटपुट ऑफ द टू फर्म्स टूगेदर वुड बी ए माइनस सी. सो ए माइनस सी इज द टोटल आउटपुट ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री. पूरी की पूरी इंडस्ट्री में ए माइनस सी आउटपुट है. सो जो हमने अभी रिएक्शन कर्व निकाला, विच इज Q1 इज इक्वल टू A माइनस सी माइनस Q2 अपॉन 2, दिस इज माई टोटल इंडस्ट्री आउटपुट. दिस इज माई टोटल इंडस्ट्री आउटपुट विच आई गेट वेन आई सेट P टू बी इक्वल टू C और MC, राइट? इसके अंदर क्योंकि हम पूरा का पूरा आउटपुट प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं, इसीलिए जो सुपर नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट है फर्म वन के और फर्म टू के वो जीरो है। इसीलिए अगर हमारे को क्वांटिटी जो है वो जीरो से ज्यादा चाहिए बर्ट्रांड के अंदर, यू नो, सो माय टोटल प्रॉफिट आर हियर जीरो, सो माय क्वांटिटी विल बी जीरो इफ ए इज इक्वल टू सी, बट इफ ए इज ग्रेटर देन सी ओनली देन द बर्ट्रांड क्वांटिटी कैन बी पॉजिटिव, विच इज व्हाट वी आर अज्यूमिंग आउट हियर। व्हाट वी आर अज्यूमिंग आउट हियर इज दैट द फर्म एक्चुअली हैज मोर कैपेसिटी टू प्रोड्यूस द गुड्स व्हिच आर रिक्वायर्ड टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड टू हैव the production more than the cost, otherwise my production will be less than the cost, so I will never be able to produce the goods at all. This will become more clear when I do one additional video towards the end, which is of capacity constraints, but right now let's just take that as a background. Then it will be easy for you to compare it to Cournot. So in the Cournot we have this. This I've already solved for you, right? So pi function of the first firm is PQ into Q1 minus CQ1, जो भी हमने सॉल्व किया था ये आता है, जिसको हमने अभी फर्दर सॉल्व किया था, wherein we had said that Q1 is nothing but A minus C minus Q2 upon 2, and Q2 is equal to A minus C minus Q1 by 2. When you solve them simultaneously together, you get Q1 star is equal to Q2 star is equal to A minus C upon 3. Now, this is coming out to be same. These two are coming out to be same because C1 and C2 are same. If C1 and C2 were not equal, then Q1 star and Q2 star also will not be equal. So, given that you have A and C, you can figure out the production. What it also means is that the total quantity that the two firms together are producing or the industry is producing is 2/3 of A by C, which is 2/3 of the market. 2/3 of the market se matlab hai, 1/3 of the market will always remain unfulfilled so that P is greater than C. अगर हम 1/3 ऑफ द मार्केट को अनफुलफिल नहीं रखेंगे तो P ग्रेटर देन C नहीं रहेगा, P विल कम आउट टू बी इक्वल टू C. सेकेंड थिंग इज व्हेन यू पुट Q हियर यू कैन एक्चुअली फाइंड आउट P, बिकॉज यू नो दैट P इज नथिंग बट A माइनस Q. आपके पास ये Q है, सो इफ यू डू दैट यू कैन एक्चुअली फिगर आउट P. सो P इज नथिंग बट A प्लस टू C बाय 3. सो वॉट यू डिड A माइनस दिस Q. And when you have these, you can actually figure out the profits of the first and the second firm. Pi star is equal to pi 2 star becomes equal to 2 by 9 A minus C squared. Easy to calculate. You can actually just use these figures to calculate. In case you were to face a problem, send me a WhatsApp and I'll sort it out for you. Then that brings us to the next thing, which is perfect Cartle. We're not done with Cournot. We'll come back to Cournot. But you see, Cournot, हम तब तक अच्छे से रियलाइज नहीं कर पाते जब तक हम कार्टल को स्टडी नहीं करते. सो वी आर एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू स्टडी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन Cournot एंड कार्टल. सो फॉर दैट नो दैट फॉर द परफेक्ट कार्टल पाई वन प्लस पाई टू इज मैक्सिमाइज. सो फॉर द परफेक्ट कार्टल वी मैक्सिमाइज जॉइंट प्रॉफिट. सो वॉट इज जॉइंट प्रॉफिट? The profit of the first firm plus the profit of the second firm, right? What do? We do del pi 1 plus pi 2 upon del Q1, which is equal to del pi 1 plus pi 2 upon del Q2, which is nothing but A minus 2Q1 minus 2Q2 minus C. So, the joint quantity that the two firms together will be producing will be A by C upon 2, which is half the market. And the price then they will be having will obviously be A plus C upon 2. Again, you did A minus Q. And the profits that the two firms together will be having will be A by C square upon 4, which means the two firms individually will have 1/8 of the profit if the firms are producing the same quantity, which we cannot say, which could be anything else also. So you know what would be a good exercise for you guys to do? Take A to be some value, take C to be some value, and compare the profit here of the industry together and in Cournot that we did abhi thodi der pehle for the two firms together. And I'll actually tell you the book example. You can take A to be equal to 120 and you can take C to be equal to 0. So then you will be able to calculate the profit here and the profit in the Cournot model you just did. So this is my Cournot best response curve. This is my Cournot's best response curves. So what I did? I did BR1 is equal to, BR1 as a function of Q2, which is nothing but Q1 is equal to A minus C minus Q2 upon 2. I'm assuming A to be 120, C to be 0, so it's 120 minus Q2 upon 2. So herein, when Q2 is 0, then Q1 is equal to A minus C. And when Q2 is 0, then it is A minus C by 2. So maine isko use karke bana liya. So which means that in this example of ours, when Q1 is 0, this is 120, and this will right here be 60. Similarly, BR2 is Q2 is equal to A minus C minus Q1 by 2, which is nothing but 120 here and 60 here, right? So when you solve it, you get these to be A minus C by 3, A minus C by 3, which is nothing but 120 by 3, which is 40. So this is also 40 and this is also 40. So in a way, I can say that the total quantity of the firm is, if the industry is 80, when firm 1 and firm 2 are individually producing 40 each, right? So 120 mera total market tha, usme se 40 inhone produce kiya. These lines are called ISO profit lines. So what I did was, I figured out the profit of firm 1. The profit of firm 1 is PQ1 minus CQ1. P is nothing but A minus Q1 minus Q2, the whole into Q1 minus Q1, given that C is 0. C is 0, na? A minus Q1 minus Q2, the whole Q1 minus Q1. So, I can rewrite it as, हमारे पास ये profit function है, हमें पता है कि हमारा जो Q1 है, वो Q2 के ऊपर dependent है, and this is my entire profit function. So, what we are trying to say is, if I write 100 here, if I write 100 here, which is a fixed one, and I write this as A minus Q1 minus Q2, the whole into Q1 minus Q1, तो हम लोग ऐसे multiple Q1 और Q2 की quantities निकाल सकते हैं, जैसे हमारे पास ये line plot होगी. You know, why is this line like this? You can actually prove it to have a maxima. You could rewrite this equation with Q1 on one side, Q2 on the other side. You could do del Q2 by del Q1 and prove it to be equal to 0 and then figure out del square Q2 upon del Q1 square and prove it to have a maxima. Having said that, it's not going to solve any purpose because it's not really needed in your exams. What is needed in your exams? For you to know ki bhai ye inverted U shape hai. Kaise aaye hai? Not really important. Second important thing, ki hamare paas is pure ke pure first yellow line pe pi 1 is equal to 100 y line pe pure ke pure curve pe profit constant hai, which is 100. Hum Q1, Q2 ko change karte hai, multiple hamare paas quantities aati hai. Hamare paas abhi firm ka kya profit hai? Wo hum figure out karenge is line se. So this is my profit of the firm currently. This green line shows me the current profit because it passes through E. Second thing we also need to know is, as we move to a lower ISO profit line, my profit increases. As I move to a lower ISO profit line, my profit increases. How? Take a vertical straight line. Yahan pe Q1 same hai, but here Q2 is lower and here Q2 is higher. We know that as Q2 increases, price is going to fall for both the firms, which implies profit for my firm will also fall. Profit for my firm will also fall. Right? Thik bola na maine? Right? I hope you got that. So when profit is falling, that's why we are saying the higher up we go, the lower profit there is for firm 1. The lower down we come, the higher profit there is for a firm. Which means that कि जैसे-जैसे हम अपने lower and lower ISO profit line पे move करते जाएंगे, वैसे-वैसे इस particular firm का जो profit है वो increase होता जाएगा. Let's talk about shifting of the best response curves. Shifting of the BR curves. अगर दोनों firms का marginal cost बढ़ जाता है, then both the curves will fall inside, will come inside. जब मेरा cost बढ़ेगा, मैं कम produce करूँगी, दोनों BR curves shift कर जाएंगे. मेरा जो Q1 था, उसका BR curve क्या था? A minus C minus Q2 upon 2. So if my C rises, the entire for every Q2, my Q1 falls. And similarly for the other one, so it moves inwards. And अगर सिर्फ C1 rise करता है, तो सिर्फ BR1 shift होगा, BR2 constant रहेगा. Plain and simple, right? So in the multiple firm example, which is the n firm example, I want to take an example. So pi 1 is, we know this, we have already solved for this. Now we are not saying there are two firms. Now n is not restricted to 2, n is n number of firms, right? So we just changed the example a little bit. So we are saying now Q, the capital Q, is going to be Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, so on and so forth till Qn, which I can write as Q1 plus the capital Q minus I. Matlab, so this is the Q of the ith firm, and this is the Q, the capital Q is the quantity of all the firms except the ith firm. Quantity of all the firms except the ith firm. So which is why we can rewrite it like this, and which is why I've changed Q to reflect this one right here. So for the ith firm, or for the first firm, we do del Q1 by del Qi. For the simplicity, maine isko 1 le liya, and this actually becomes n minus 1, or it can be actually Q minus 1. Ek hi baat hai. So then it becomes A minus 2 Q1 minus Q minus 1 minus C is equal to 0. Aise hi aayega na? Aap dekho isko. This will be A minus Q1 ki jagah 2 Q1 minus Q minus 1 minus C is equal to 0. Again, I'm rewriting it. This is Q1 plus Q minus 1. Although books mein nahi diya hua, I hi use kiya hua hai book mein. I've just done that to make it look a little easier to you. Ab hame kya karna hai? Hum isse best response firm उसका Q1 का निकाल सकते हैं, विच इज नथिंग बट Q1 इज इक्वल टू A माइनस C माइनस Q माइनस 1 अपॉन 2. दिस इज द बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स कर्व ऑफ फर्म 1, राइट. ऑल्सो वी नो दैट Q माइनस 1 इज नथिंग बट Q स्टार, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द इक्विलिब्रियम, माइनस Q1 स्टार, which is nothing but n into Q1 star minus Q1 star, which is nothing but n minus 1 the whole into Q1 star, right? Which also means that A minus 2 Q1 star is A minus 2 Q1 star minus, मैं सिर्फ इसी को ही ले रही हूँ अब, इसको मैंने यहाँ पे ऐसे rewrite किया, A minus 2 Q1 star minus, अब मैं Q minus 1 की जगह, can I write this? N minus 1 वाला? I can ना? Minus n minus 1 into Q1 star minus C is equal to 0, right? Or Q1 star is nothing but A minus C upon n plus 1. Now this is what I wanted to prove, and I also want to then prove that Q star, which is nothing but n into Q1 star, is nothing but n upon n plus 1 into A minus C. What it means is ki agar mere paas 3 firms hain, to har ek firm kitna produce karegi? 1/4. टोटल इंडस्ट्री कितना प्रोड्यूस करेगी? 3/4. अगर मेरे पास 4 फर्म्स हैं, देन ईच फर्म विल प्रोड्यूस 1/5, एंड देन द टोटलिटी ऑफ इंडस्ट्री विल प्रोड्यूस 4/5. सो ऐसे ही इमेजिन करो, अगर मेरे पास 1000 फर्म्स हैं, देन ईच फर्म विल प्रोड्यूस 1000th ऑफ द आउटपुट, एंड द टोटल इंडस्ट्री विल प्रोड्यूस 1000 अपॉन 1001 ऑफ द आउटपुट, विच इज अ वेरी स्मॉल आउटपुट विच इज नॉट बीइंग प्रोड्यूस. सो पी विल बी रियली रियली क्लोज टू सी. जितना हम क्वांटिटी ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस करते जाते हैं, उतना ही पी हमारा कम होता जाता है. सो एज यू प्रोड्यूस मोर एंड मोर क्वांटिटी, आर पी इज लेसर एंड लेसर. वी नो दैट ये हमारा डिमांड कर्व है, ये MR कर्व है, and this is my MC curve. The moment I'm moving closer and closer towards, I'm producing more and more quantity, my P is going to keep on falling and be closer and closer to MC. So jitni meri N zyada hai, utna hi hamara P jo hai, that's going to be closer to MC. You can actually use this, put it back here in the P function and figure out P, figure out the profit of each firm and profit of all the firms.